As the journey to CARIFTA 2013 continues, Bahamas Athletics recently covered a reception featuring Puma as the new choice brand for track and field in the Bahamas. At this event, the highlight also included the launch of Team Bahamas Puma gear.
Obviously, it's a highlight. They're trying to promote here, especially with the young team like the CARIFTA. I know a lot of individuals are probably asking about the colors and so forth. It'll grow on them, but this is the time of a trend now with fashion. But before I go on any further, Mr. President.
Thank you and good afternoon. Sport fan, Mike Sands, President of Beach Race, Larry, past Secretary General of the Bahamas Olympic Committee, fellow sports enthusiasts, good evening. This is another beautiful evening for us in sports as we come to look at this fine uniform that Puma has now come on board to sponsor the Beach Race and the Bahamas Olympic Committee. Once again, we will be outstanding at any opening ceremony. As you all know, the Bahamas always take the cake and everything. I think last Olympic, they told me the Bahamas was the best dressed team of a magazine from New York. I don't know if anybody has seen that. But we love Puma. Puma's of high standard. And I'm happy with the contract that we have with Puma. For the first time, our contract called for incentive for athletes when they perform well, gold, silver, and bronze. We also have the incentive of Special Olympic is included in this contract. So we are happy and we are proud to be part of Puma. And I know the Bahamian athletes are going to make Puma proud, just as we do any other person who sponsors us. So this afternoon, it's a short evening, the master of ceremony always just said. So let us enjoy and look around at these beautiful uniform that for the first time, I believe, will be christened with the CARIFTA team. And Bahamian will get the chance to see the Bahamian athletes with these fine uniform on. Those shoes, they're pretty light, and I'm sure that some record's going to be set with those in the Bahamas. I feel them, and I feel like I could go with myself. You got to get back in up there. But thanks Puma on behalf of the Bahamas Olympic Committee for coming forward and so early and sponsoring us. So we must have something good to offer. Thank you very much.
President of the B3As, Mr. Mike Sands.
First of all, appreciative to Puma for coming forward. As we all know, we had an agreement with another entity. At the end of the day, we talk about business decisions. And the opportunities were there for those to support our efforts. Our program is a very, very expensive program. We took a business decision, and we're very, very happy with the decision that we took. You look at the colors and the questions that are being asked. Well, you know, as I heard someone say, the colors will grow on you, but I believe that Puma did a magnificent job with the short time in which they had to put the colors together for us. And the Bahamas colors are not the most easy color to put together in such a short space of time. And so we would expect that by the pen relays, we'll be in full bloom. But let us not look at the colors. Let's look at the positive side, that we've got something great that is going for us. And Puma has come to the table not just with the great incentive in terms of the financial aspect of it, but we've also entered into a grassroots program where they will also be making a more meaningful contribution to the development of our sport, and that so that our sport could continue to grow. And so on behalf of the B3As, the executive, and most importantly, the athletes, I too want to congratulate and thank Puma for heeding our call, heeding our cry, and coming to the forefront and becoming a partners with Bahamas, certainly for the next 4 years, and hopefully with our performances, with those attractive bonuses that as a part of that contract, that we will be able to go from strength to strength, and we'll be like our brothers down from the south who like to do like this, you know. So we're hoping that we will be able to at least be on par with them. And so our representative, who happens to be one of us and a homebred person in the form of Coach Henry Rolle, one of the coaches at Auburn University, I want to thank him also for his presentation to us that convinced us that this was the way to go. And so again, thank you very much. And you now have to get used to these nice fancy colors. Almost look like kryptonite, but that means strength and power. And we're going to do it. And we will be doing that starting tomorrow with the CARIFTA trials. But more importantly, after that team is selected, you will see those colors unveil March 29th through April the 1st. So don't delay. Get your tickets today. CARIFTA is here. Thank you.
Olympian Pauline Davis also shared how thrilled she was to view the new uniforms and reflects on the days in the past.
Good night, everyone. When I walk into this room tonight, I was really overcome with emotions when I saw these beautiful Bahamas uniforms. I remember back in the day when we used to wear a uniform called Crimson Dawn. And I remember competing in those uniforms. By the time you would finish running, the inside of your leg would be raw because it would constantly keep rubbing on your legs. And to walk into this room tonight and see those beautiful colors of our country, and in particular those spikes, oh my goodness. I could have done some serious damage with those Bahamian spikes. I'm a little jealous now. I have never run with a Bahamian spike on my feet. And you all know how much I love the Bahamian colors. I hope that our athletes appreciate all of the hard work that people that came before us put in and people that came before them put in for us to be able to get such beautiful uniforms. I want to say thank you to Puma for what they are doing for our beautiful country, the Bahamas, for the sponsorship that they're giving to our grassroots program. And they're going to also help out with Special Olympics. That's very, very special. And as the IWF representative from the islands of the Bahamas, I just want to say on behalf of the IWF, Puma, we want to thank you for your for you continue to give so much to all the different countries that you've been giving contributions to. And I'm just so happy that you decide to sponsor the Bahamas. And I hope I get an opportunity to wear those uniforms. Man, I won't put my feet back in one of those spikes, man. I really I hope that our kids go out there this weekend and in 2 weeks' time and just run their heart and soul out for our country. I hope that they feel the way I'm feeling right now, just standing up here. I'm no longer an athlete, but man, it makes me feel so good. Puma, you have done an amazing job. And I thank you. I thank you and from the bottom of my heart. I thank you for the athletes. I thank you for the officials of my country. But more importantly, I thank you on behalf of a grateful nation for you doing what you're doing for our little tiny dot on the map. The Bahamas, we have truly arrived. Thank you, Puma. Thank you.
We also get an up-close exclusive interview with Coach Henry Rolle and Coach Williams of Moores Island.
All right, we're here with Henry Rolle, who among other things has a role in coaching athletes and for this event tonight. This is the launch.
It's a launch of Puma and Team Bahamas.
Right.
You know, they're not official sponsor of the Bahamas Olympic Association along with the B3A. And also, Anthonique Strachan is now the poster girl for Bahamas and Puma. And that's where my role is mainly. I coach Anthonique Strachan, and a world junior champion, 100 and 200 meters. And it's a brand of choice simply because they're more of a unique company as far as a sense of fashion. And their market is more of the Caribbean and Europe, unlike where Nike, which is mostly the US. And that made it a great choice.
Now this might sound, I'm just asking as a layperson, in terms of branding, I know Puma sponsors
Usain Bolt, Jamaica.
Jamaica, right. That's not a conflict of interest.
No. Well, it's only so many companies out there, so obviously if they're going to duplicate themselves with different countries. You know, Jamaica is obviously very, very successful, very masked. And so forth, and plus Puma have done a great job with them. And the Bahamas took a look at what they have done with Jamaica and so forth, and they put themselves in the same situation.
Now I know Anthonique Strachan is one of your athletes.
Yes, ma'am.
How is she doing, and how is she handling the transformation from amateur to pro?
Well, the first thing is you got to develop as a person. And that's mainly my role. You know, helping her to understand and develop it as a person first. Secondly, you know, she's getting accustomed to going to school and running, competing full time. And she's doing really well. She loves it. She has some great individuals around her, like Karan Stewart, Shaniqua Ferguson, Bianca Stewart, to name a few, Nivea Smith, Levan Sands. She's in a great group, you know, and honestly, she has it too good because she has so many people that have gone through it that can be a great guidance to what she's about to do. But she's going to be very, very special this year, very special.
And as for you, the switch, you know, what was it like coaching in Alabama?
Yes, Auburn, Alabama.
As opposed to coaching here in the Bahamas?
Well, I coached at St. John's for 3 years. We won a national championship there, and I decided that I wanted to do something more on a broader scale, develop, and I just felt that it was more I had to offer. And I was a bit limited. And at in the college, the difference is simply mostly lie within recruiting. You know, you can't pour syrup on pancakes. I mean, syrup on bread. Just call them pancakes. You got to have that talent, and that's the key in college. Even from college football, basketball, track and field is no different. And it starts with recruiting. That's the main difference. Unlike high school, where you're pretty much stuck with the talent that you have, you know. I don't want to say it that way, but you have to develop. But it also comes a unique thing of developing that talent and balancing an individual, because they're in the most critical time of their lives as adolescents to make that transition into adulthood. And you got to play a critical role in that also. And the balance with school, being a student first and then an athlete. And then I fall in between being a coach and having to balance them. But I'm still, you know, it's tough when you want to be very good and very competitive.
Any of the athletes
who
are competing in CARIFTA?
Yeah, my nephew, Terrace Smith, he was a world junior finalist. I look for him to do great things. Miss Kamisha Cox, I've heard a lot of. I saw a little bit of her, I don't know her personally, but she's going to be a joy to watch. And the twins, obviously the twins.
Yeah,
and I can't forget the great Shanae Miller. I think she's going to rewrite the record books and so forth. Such a talent. But they're the names that come to mind when you talk about the CARIFTA and the Bahamas team.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us.
You're welcome, ma'am.
So we're here with Anthony Williams from the Moss Island Track Club. Tell us a little bit about your club and how they're doing going into this. The pre-trials for CARIFTA and, of course, CARIFTA.
Moss Island Track Club is doing very well. I have about 8 athletes down. I'm looking for a few of them to make the team to be a part of this Bahamas CARIFTA, especially James Williams. He already ran the qualifying time in the under 20 men 400, so I'm looking for him to repeat that and be a part of the team.
That's awesome. And sorry, what are some of the challenges that you face as an off-island, you know, coming into this competition?
Well, it's always ways and means to get here, you know, because I've been on a family island. It's always a financial challenge, you know. But we had Mr. Petty, is 10 of us. We got 2 rooms, you know, and so, like I tell the guys, you just got to bunk it out. Better days are coming.
And so how do you raise funds during the rest of the year, you know, for all these other track meets? Are they able to compete in these track meets that take place?
Well, this year we had BGC gave us a little sponsor. Then we have Mr. Campbell from the Workers' Cooperation, you know, he always assists us.
All right, so the kids, are they excited? And how many? I don't know if I asked you this before. How many entrants do you have in the pre-trials?
Well, I have 8. 8 entrants, yes. And I'm looking for at least about 3 to be a part of this team, hopefully.
Lavern Eve also shared about her organization and her passion for seeking out young Bahamian talent.
All right, so we're here with the incomparable Miss Lavern Eve. And my interest in her is specifically for the fact that she is so into young talent. And she's going to tell us a little bit about that. What's the name of the organization that you...
We were doing a talent search. Young athletes who can throw a softball far or baseball. We're looking mainly for baseball players because when you're dealing with baseball players and javelin throwers, the mechanics are basically the same. So we had a lot of young kids came out, and some who did not make it out, they're still coming out and trying out for, you know, to throw the javelin. I've met with like four or five already who did not make the talent search, but they're still there. They come in, and hopefully that by next year we'll have a stable of javelin throwers.
Now, you were one of the second recipients.
Second.
Of the Austin
Silly Award, yeah.
Award at CARIFTA in what year?
The first time was in 1982, right here in Nassau, and in Martinique in 83.
Oh, wow, so twice.
Aito,
could you tell me a little bit about that award?
You know, when I first started competing, when I won the award, I won all three of the events. And the first year, 1981, I didn't know you can do three events. So I probably would have won it in 81 also, but that didn't happen. But the Austin Silly Award at the time for me was, I didn't really understood what it really meant until now when I look back at it, when they said I was one of three persons who won it twice consecutively, but it's an honor. It really is. When I look back at it, I was like, wow, that's awesome.
And it's inspiring to me that you're still trying to, you know, pass on all this knowledge to younger people.
Yeah, one of my goals after and when I do finish competing is to give back. I've came across a lot of persons who have really helped me to get to where I was or where I am today in track and field. So my thing is to give back, to share the wealth, they say, to share the wealth, and to so I can inspire another young athlete to get to that point where I was or even go even further. So it is great to see the smiles on their face and how enthused they are, the ones that I'm working with, because especially for CARIFTA, they're ready for CARIFTA. In a way, in a sense, but I am now like an athlete, but for the athletes.
Okay.
Yeah, through the B3As.
Like a mama bear.
Yeah.
Awesome. So what are your predictions? Because I'm sure you know the teams that are going into the pre-trials this weekend. What are your predictions for the as well?
As far as in the throwing or total? Well, in the field events, for the javelin, I've been dealing mostly with the javelin. We have a young boy, under 20, Denzel Pratt. Very good. I think he will medal. We have another young, under 17, javelin thrower, Ferguson, who has qualified in the BISS meet. So hopefully, for sure, those two, they medal, you know, podium standard. The rest of them are still trying. They're very close. So I have to give them some mental talk and try to encourage them that, you know, that they can do it too. So we'll see what happens come this weekend.
Are they looking at any particular person from the Caribbean that they want to compete against if they get into the CARIFTA finals?
Well, there are two boys from Grenada, I think, under 20, that we're kind of watching. So I don't remember their names. But when I talk to them, I basically tell them, you cannot worry about anybody else. Just do what you have to do. Trust what you've been doing and just go out and have fun and perform.
And how awesome is it that Puma is sponsoring CARIFTA this year?
Man, that's very awesome. I looked at the uniform, I was like, will I get a chance to get in one of these?
When you were competing in your events, what was that like? It was so many years ago. What was it like for athletes in terms of sponsorship and in terms of just uniforms and stuff like that?
You know, at the time, I went through several sponsors. Mizuno sponsored us one time. Nike has sponsored us. Now we just with Adidas. The athletes look forward to the uniforms. Now it's like, wow, Puma. So it's a transition that we're trying to get used to, or I think we'll do good. I think we'll do great. It's growing.
So
So yeah.
Greg Cash, head coach of the CARIFTA Games, offered his insights on the honor of being able to showcase the junior talent within the Caribbean.
So I'm here with Greg
Cash,
the head coach for the CARIFTA Games. This is like the real CARIFTA, not the trials. CARIFTA.
Yes.
How awesome is that to have that honor?
Well, it's definitely a privilege and honor to be recognized in such a great, what we would want to say world class, because basically it showcases all the talent, junior talent in the Caribbean, which we know has been showcasing the world, because most of the junior athletes who come through the Caribbean would have gone on and become world champions.
Okay, so who are you looking forward to medaling in the competition that's coming up?
Well, definitely there's some names that jump right out at you, but we don't want to jump the gun in any kind of way. We want to basically leave things in God's hand. He has his way of working things out, and I'm sure those athletes who know they have the potential to go out and medal will definitely go out and give their best. Definitely, you would want to say persons like Shawnee Miller would be one of the athletes that definitely have a bright light as we look towards these games. And there's others who are right there with her, but we want to say with God's help, we know we as a nation will go out and do our part.
We're at pre-trials, that's over. What's gonna be the process coming into the CARIFTA Games? What are the athletes gonna be expected to be doing?
Well, definitely you'd wanna put it in stages as how you would take a training season. You say you've had the preseason where you've gone through your training. Now you have, you had the off season where you went through the training, all the strength training, all the conditioning. You went through the preseason now where you've gone through basically some of the club meets, high school meets, and now you're in the season. The season is upon us now. We go through the trials this weekend, and after the trials is basically the big show. We in March, and college basketball, I call it March Madness. And basically, throughout the Caribbean, we know this is March Madness for track and field, because every Easter weekend, we look forward to having the CARIFTA Games. And this year is no exception. And one of the greatest things that we have is that we're going to have it right here at home.
Yes.
So all the Bahamians will have the hot cross bun on Good Friday.
Come out,
and then come out on Saturday and get ready to cheer.
A number of Caribbean countries coming to participate. How many Caribbean countries will be participating?
Right now, we have about 25 countries that are going to participate. I think the number is 26, 27. So basically, we have everybody in the Caribbean. I think it's one or two countries that hasn't confirmed. And I don't know if that has changed since the last time they had given the number count. But definitely 25 nations inside Nassau is going to be a show that everybody should come out and see.
As a coach, is there any athletes from the Caribbean? Are there any athletes from the Caribbean that you are specifically watching who you've been telling your athletes about, or will be telling your athletes about, to watch and speed their time and all that stuff?
Definitely, you would want to preempt them on some of the athletes who would be in the races or the jumps or throws that they're in. Right now, we haven't gotten the team. The team hasn't been picked as yet. But Jamaica and Trinidad would have had their trials, and their team have already been named. And I've seen some of the times, some of the jumps, some of the throws, and definitely once our team is picked. As a coach, then you would want to mobilize those coaches who would be responsible for all the different areas, all the different disciplines, and let them know, well, you know, these are some of the names that you have to look forward to. We try not to have a strong mindset of just trying to scare the athletes out, but to just basically give them awareness. And all you want to do is basically have them aware that, hey, Jamaica's bringing somebody, and Trinidad is bringing somebody, or Barbados, or whoever it is, and they would be persons that you want to keep your eyes on if you're in their heats, or if you're not in their heats, maybe take a look at them and maybe see what they're doing right, see what they're doing wrong, and use that as a strategy when you go to compete against them.
Thank you so much for talking to me, and best of luck at CARIFTA.
Bahamas Athletics Road to CARIFTA 2013 coverage is brought to you by Sky Bahamas, R.E.J. Sands, the Bahamas Ministry of Tourism, the Bahamas Ministry of Youth Sports and Culture, Jazztel, and Sage Eden Media Group. We invite you to continue to follow Bahamas Athletics for all of your CARIFTA updates, results, and stories. Bahamas Athletics, Fast Track News, number one in the field.